Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I have a weekly grocery haul for you guys. It's not very big because I do try to go just once a week if I can. And we just need a whole bunch this week. So, get into it. So, we needed brown sugar. So, the Domino brand was cheaper than the store brand for some reason. Like, a dollar cheaper. So, got that. Got these extra wide egg noodles. I'm going to make a beef stroganoff this week. Just some leaf lettuce, some lettuce for salad. I don't really like to get I prefer like this over bagged salads. They are more convenient, but this is just usually a lot cheaper and lasts a little bit longer, I think. Kraft single slices for my hubby requested those. Campbell's cans of tomato juice. There's like 6 cans in here. This is I really like this as a snack. Like ice cold tomato juice. I love tomato juice or vegetable juice. And it's only 3 points, smart points per can. So I thought that would be kind of a good extra just to get your veggies in if you haven't had a lot of veggies for the day. And again, I just like it as a snack. Honey Nut Cheerios. I bought last week the, Walmart brand, and hubby said they are not good, and I have to agree, they are not good. And I'm normally like a fan of generic cereal, like it's totally fine, it's way cheaper, but so I got him just a small box. We're gonna try to mix it in with the cheaper and so we can go through it. Some strawberries. I had a coupon for a free Dan and Light and Fit yogurt in that influencer box that I showed you guys. So I picked up the strawberry cheesecake flavor. It sounded really good. There's only 80 calories, and this is 2 smart points in this little guy. There's no fat, it says. So let's see what the sugar is. 7 grams of sugar, 9 carbs. So anyways, that sounded good, and it was free, so I thought I would try that out. I haven't really had a whole lot of Danon. I usually get the Chobani Greek yogurt or the Noosa Aussie-style yogurt that I showed you guys in my last haul, I think. So, yeah. Seedless English cucumber for snacks and salads. I love those. This trip was a little more expensive because I needed, like, some spices and stuff, and those are always just kind of expensive. But I needed ground mustard, ground sage, and then I needed a new pepper grinder. I was almost out. I've been using, I'll show you the one I really like. I've been using for a couple years now, this Alessi brand, and it's whole mixed peppercorns. I really like this. It's got like, I don't know if it's going to focus because it's in a clear thing. There you go. But it's got a bunch of different color of peppercorns in here, not just black. And it's a nice little grinder. But they didn't have that brand at my Meijer. They just had this McCormick one, which looks pretty similar. But you can see it's got like pink and green and white and black peppercorns. So anyways, I just like to use that when I'm cooking and seasoning stuff. Sour cream for that stroganoff I'm going to make. Ground beef for the stroganoff. This is one of, and I'll try to link it below, because I think this is the actual video of her making it, but I swear, I'm not obsessed with Shelly from Shelly's Home Life, but she's just has some really good recipe. Every recipe I've tried of hers has been really good, and she puts, like, she's on Weight Watchers too, so she will put in points if she knows the points on stuff. I just really like her channel, and like I said, I have tried a bunch of her recipes, and they've all been really good, and really easy to make, so, and family pleasers. So, anyways, got that for that. This, was kind of a splurgy item, because this is the A&W 10 root beer. So it's not diet, but it only has 10 calories per serving instead of the normal like 170 and like only 2 grams of sugar. And this says for 12 ounces. And then I looked up on smart points, and for 12 ounces, it's only 1 smart point. So I just got this instead of a whole case of cans, because I just thought it'd be a fun thing to try. Splurge on. And then I also got this Meijer brand. These are 0 points. These little, like Crystal Light type powder drink mix in things. I got the raspberry lemonade. I think there's 10. Yeah, there's 10 in here for me and the hubby to share. Dark chocolate. I've been all about it lately, you guys. So I picked up, I normally will get the sugar-free Jell-O, because I think that is like 0 points plus, or smart points. But I wanted the chocolate pudding. So this is 60 calories sugar-free. It's only 2 points, 2 smart points. So I just thought that would be a nice little snack, dessert kind of thing. The turkey is more for my hubby, but I just wanted to see. It's only 1 point for 2 ounces of this ultra-thin Hillshire Farm oven roasted turkey breast. I got a pork tenderloin. I'm going to make some pulled pork in the crock pot this week. Got a dozen eggs. My favorite bread is this Sara Lee Honey Wheat, and it's only 2 points per slice, so it's not too bad, but we were out of bread. Mostly, it's, like I said, for the hubby, because he'll have sandwiches with the cheese and the turkey, so I'll freeze one loaf, and we'll eat on one. And then, some non-food things. We need a toilet paper. It's not very exciting. It's just Charmin. I found a lot of really good deals at my Meijer, just up and down the aisles. So, I was going to get, because I've seen those, like, I'm not even sure what they're called. Rubbermaid makes them, I think. They're like the Smart Saver, Produce Saver kind of things. They're just, I think it's also, yeah, Rubbermaid. They're kind of expensive. Like a big one is like $13 or $14. But they have these on clearance for 75% off. And this is a value pack. So it's got a couple, I think two. It's a, how many are in here? It has one. Sorry, they put the stickers over everything. It's got two containers, so one 14 cup, this big one, and then one 5 cup container, and then it's got this little, like, insert in the bottom that's supposed to help, I don't know, keep your produce longer. So, I just thought that would be really good, because a lot of times, like, lately I've been getting fresh fruit and just cutting it up and sticking it in a Rubbermaid thing, so that would be good for $3. I thought that was just a good deal. And then, I just picked up a sports bra. These are really nice. This brand that I've been getting from Meijer, I really, really like it. It's MTA Sport. It's medium impact. I more get them, not, I mean, for sport, but also just for, like, they're really comfortable to wear around the house. And they're these fun colors. I get it in a larger size because I'm a large-chested woman. So, anyways, they're $16. The last time I got one, it was half off, but this time it was, I'm not even sure, it was only, like, $11, so that's not bad. And then I did get some of this descaling stuff for our Keurig because I really need to do it. It's gross. But it was 75% off too. It was only $1.25. So thought that was a good deal. And then skincare stuff. They had a ton of skincare items on clearance. And Clean and Clear is usually the brand that I go to. So I stocked up on some stuff. I love this Night Relaxing Deep Cleaning Face Wash. It's oil-free. They had just this by itself on clearance for like $1 or something. That was like all 75% off. But I went ahead and just picked up this double pack because I have it. I have tried the Morning Burst. I like it. And I don't really have a morning cleanser. So I went ahead and just got that for face wash for $2.37 for two of these. That's an awesome deal. I got some of these wipes. $1.31 for 25 wipes. Walmart brand is not even that cheap, so that was a really good deal. And I love the nighttime stuff a lot. And then this is just a hydrating gel moisturizer, and it was only $1.45, so I just thought this would be a good, like, daytime moisturizer, because I'm not very good about wearing moisturizer, and I wish this was, like, I wanted to see if there was, like, any SPF or anything in it. I don't think so, because it's a gel moisturizer. Let's see. Okay, it's not like an SPF one, but it just says it's ultra lightweight and won't clog your pores, provides a touch of moisture. So, anyways, really awesome deal. So definitely check out. They had, like, it wasn't just Clean and Clear. There was Clearasil, I think some Neutrogena. I can't even think of the other brands. But yeah, they had a bunch of different brands, really cheap. I don't know if that means that maybe they're changing the packaging on this stuff, or I hope it doesn't mean that they're not going to carry it anymore, because like I said, this is like my go-to. I love this night relaxing deep cleaning face wash from Clean and Clear. I love it. It has a nice gentle scent, and it's just a really nice light cleanser. So anyways, yeah, so that was everything. I spent like $81, I think, but some of this came out, like, this part of my budget. Normally, I like to, for our budget, I'm trying to stick to $62, $63 per week, basically, because I go to the bank every pay period, so I only go to the bank to do the cash envelopes twice a month, basically, so every other week, and so I just take out $125 for groceries to last us for 2 weeks, which it usually does, and usually have a little left over, depending, like if I have to buy meat, which I did, but this was a really cheap deal. I don't know if you guys saw this pork. I was going to show you that. Was $13.26. It was on sale for $4.40, so, and this, I mean, I'm going to cut this in half and freeze one section and then cook one, and we're going to have tons of leftovers from that even, I think. But meat is always the thing that gets you. I think it's expensive. This comes out of my household budget. So does this, and so does this. And then this comes out of, like, personal care budget, and this will come out of our clothing budget. So really, I probably did stick closer to the $60 that I try to spend. And some of these things, like, this wasn't necessary, but I just wanted to try it. It was only a dollar or something. And, like, the spices were a little expensive, but I kind of needed them for some recipes, and those will last for a while. And also, the tomato juice was kind of a splurge item for, not a splurge, but just like, we didn't need it. It's just, I like it as a snack, basically. Okay, anyways, that is everything, you guys. And I can show you my Okay, so I just thought I would quickly show you my cash envelopes. I just made these. I can see if I can find the template again. I found a template like on Pinterest, and I just got cute scrapbook paper and made my own little cash envelopes, and then just used glue, or you can get like that roller tape stuff. Anyways, and then I just write each one, you know, what category it is. So groceries. So this is my goal monthly to spend on groceries, $250. So biweekly, $120. So every time I go to the bank, like I said, I go every pay period, I take that much out for just groceries. And then, so that's kind of the breakdown. Then if I spend that much per week, then that's my budget, basically. If that makes sense. So, and then I've got, you know, just all this. I can do a whole video on just my cash envelopes if you guys are interested. The different categories that we have and kind of how it works for us. But it's been working really pretty well. I was doing it a while ago and I kind of got out of the habit, and I'm getting back into the habit again. Partially because my sister-in-law got me back in this weird, because she's been doing the Dave Ramsey budget system, which kind of goes over this, I think, too. So she definitely motivated me. So yay, shout out to my sister-in-law. But anyways, yeah, so these are my cash envelopes. And let me know if you would like to see a video on these, just down below in the comments. And I can go over more in detail, like, how everything breaks down and how I made the actual envelopes themselves. Because, yeah, I thought they just needed to be cute. You know? Anyways. All right. Well, that is everything. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you're having a great day. Bye.